when we're going to be using AI augmented software, at least for software development, in the short term, is probably we're going to be using it in DevOps. We are going to call semi-autonomous or autonomous software systems, that is systems that self-monitor and actually fix their own issues without human intervention. And they're going to be used in human guided AI development, which means currently what you do as a software developer is like you might write some code and your development environment might suggest some code to add, some modification, might help you write the test a little bit by generating like the base templates, that kind of stuff. That's going to change. Now we're going to prompt and tell the software what we actually wanted to do. Like say, for example, write something that reverses a sentence and it generates the function palindrome. And then you go check it and modify it, so you don't have to start from scratch while writing software. Also, the other thing where I see it really improving the lives of software engineers is in automatic testing generation. And there's something called test-driven development. In test-driven development, you write your tests before actually writing the code for those tests. This new kind of software is gonna allow us to actually do not having to need to write those tests, but have those tests write themselves from the natural language description of what the software should do. So those are the big things that I see coming in the short term. All the stuff I mentioned before is like, that's just like tip of the iceberg. There's some really exciting work that's being done to actually do much more powerful and build much more powerful tools. For example, I can think of the work of Professor Talia Ringer, who is working at the University of Illinois in Urbana-Champaign, and she works in what's called proof repair. And that basically, when we actually have tools right now to verify software, to make sure that it does what it does by actually just checking the code. But those tools are real brittle. They take a long, long time to use. NASA uses them, but they're really expensive to use because it makes developing software real small. And of course, whenever you change software, the requirements change. You have to change and re-verify your proof that your code actually does what it does. So what Professor Ringer is working on is on using techniques from programming language and machine learning to actually allow everyday developers to verify their code and make sure that it has no bugs from the instant it's written, and to be able to change the code and evolve the code as requirements change without it being really expensive and hard to re-verify that it actually does the new thing that it should do. So that, for example, is one of the new things that some of the work that's being done. And that's really exciting because once we can do that, it totally changes the face of how we do software engineering. It's like, once bugs become something that you can catch while you're writing the code itself, instead of having to wait for tests and to put it in production, and it's a game changer. So yeah, that's one of the things I'm looking forward to really a lot, because that's going to be exciting. That's going to allow us to do some amazing projects, tackle incredibly more complex things than we can right now.